Now, Jay is looking a little bit funny right now because of the fact that there's no club or disco to dance in this scene. And my stage is looking a little bit empty. So you know what? We're going to have to give him a bit of a dance floor. Let's go down to the left-hand side of the screen where it says New Backdrop. You could sort of think that a backdrop is like the background that you would see in a painting or any piece of art. Except for this, you have a whole number of backdrops to choose from. Similar features exist here to the sprite selection. You can either choose from a library, make your own, upload a file that you already have, or go ahead and take a picture. Now, that might look kind of weird because if Jay's dancing on my face, I don't think that would really be happening in a disco. So let's go ahead and find a scene that would probably more accurately represent what a disco would actually look like. Go ahead and click on the stage right here, and you'll notice that at the top, the tab that did say costumes for our sprite now says backdrops. Click on that, and it'll take you to this option where you can actually go ahead and select from the same four items. Go to the library, draw a new backdrop, upload a file, or take a picture. For the sake of the fact that we need a disco, let's go ahead and look at the library again. Look at all these options. Perfect. We'll do the same thing that we did before. Go to the music and dance theme. And here, party room. Excellent. Click on that. Okay. And there you go. The perfect setting for Jay to go ahead and get his groove on. Now, one thing to note is that we still technically have our old backdrop. The new backdrop is on top of it right now. So let's go ahead, click on the old backdrop, and exit out so we don't have to worry about it anymore. Boom. We've got our backdrop, we've got our sprite, and now I'd say you're ready to go ahead and try your own. There's one more thing I have to tell you before I go ahead and send you on your way. You'll notice up here in the upper left-hand corner, it has the word untitled. From now on in these videos, you're going to see this is filled in, because every Scratch project should have its own individual name. For the sake of this one, let's go ahead and call it Jay Goes to a Scratch Dance Party. Perfect. So when I save it, every time I open it up, it's going to be titled Jay Goes to a Scratch Dance Party. As we go through, look up there in the corner to see fun messages from us and some creative ideas for different titles that you can give to your Scratch projects.